the reality is that we're a huge net positive wherever we go. That net positive takes a couple of different shapes. You know, there's the very simple example that, you know, we're buying power that nobody else was buying before we showed up. And so we represent net new revenue streams to whether it's utilities or an open market or just the generator themselves. Like, these are employment hubs within communities. So every net new dollar of revenue and therefore profitability they're able to generate gets plowed back into the systems that they run. You know, number one is we're an economic good. Number two is that we're an engineering good, which is that, you know, depending on the type of contract you structure, depending on the type of program you participate in, there's an opportunity to support the reliability and stability of the overall system, right? So we represent a, you know, really important layer of economic stabilizing, but also, you know, engineering stabilizing for these systems as well. The third piece of it is really around the generators, where I think what we've seen, you know, in certainly the last several years is that some of these energy generators are especially those who are operating the most stabilizing power sources are struggling to monetize. And so, you know, the grid is as reliable as the energy is available, right? So if demand exceeds supply, you know, you got to go buy it from somewhere else. And you know, we already talked about kind of the loss around transmission. So these systems can go from very efficient to very inefficient quickly, just based on the type of energy blend that they're interacting with. So, you know, the Bitcoin miner plays this critical role, you know, increasing the economic viability of the power producers writ large, but also making sure that the service that they're delivering is well sustained, and that can be achieved, you know, contractually and otherwise.